Hello, I'm calling from the Trib. I'd like to confirm a quote.
Get me right around for 2 hours. I'm coming up
approximately how much money was involved. Was it over $1,000? Was it over $10,000?
Okay, where's the board hit you?
Didn't hit me, just missed.
Look like you got clipped.
No, I'm okay.
So you were lucky. All right, you and your friend, you use the beach down there beyond the rock. That's for swimmers. Stay away from here till around noon.
Okay. Now, do you want down for those kids? You're gonna cut him in two.
Take it easy.
I didn't try to hit him, mister.
Funny how you just missed him.
Look, just keep on jogging, okay, Pop? It's good for the old ticker.
You put a horn on that thing, Moose. You honk for pedestrians.
Surfers here, swimmers down there, the bundles out.
Not overwhelmed with a sense of guilt, is he?
He wouldn't mind sticking that board in your ear if he got in his way.
What's the SS symbol? I saw the same thing up on a wall up the beach.
Surf soldiers. They're a gang. They hang out along here. This is their stretch. 48th Street down to the drain pipe.
The SS reminds me of Hitler. Those Nazi stormtroopers.
Believe me, they wouldn't know what that means. They just know it bothers people. It makes them uncomfortable.
Makes me uncomfortable.
Well, they try and run this beach. They're not above pushing intruders around. But we keep them in line most of the time.
It's a big ocean. Is there room enough for everybody?
It gets crowded for surfers. You see, there's only a few primo spots like this along the coast. There's only so many waves per set. Room only for one rider per wave.
Maybe they should all take numbers and stand in line.
Yeah, of course. So, how's your new house? You happy with it?
It's not new. It's 25 years old.
What's that architecture?
Eisenhower Colonial. I don't know what it is. Contemporary, I guess. The neighborhood's real nice. It's quiet. The people who owned the house before us, they didn't hear too well, so we have a set of door chimes that sound like London on VE Day. Ted's gonna fix it.
Did you hear about the Denver record?
I know, it's in trouble. Oh, no, it folded.
Like Barnum's tent, the loans they were waiting for fell through.
Well, that's another 150 reporters on the sidewalk.
Yeah, the young ones will land on their feet, and the older ones who are ready to retire won't get hurt too bad, but the ones in the middle, with the kids in school and the mortgage payments to meet, boy, I'd hate to be in their position.
I think I am in their position. Hey, what about Rosemary Dolan?
What about her?
Well, with the record gone, she's available. Oh, she's such a beautiful writer. Her columns are so original. They're so funny. The stuff I wrote for my high school paper was Imitation Rosemary Dolan. Wouldn't it be great if the Trib went after her?
Oh, the Trib won't move fast enough. This management's arthritic.
Yeah. The Beach is broken up into these little groups. 34th Street guys, punkers, Little Tokyo, cruisers, valleys.
Yeah, they're all very clannish and territorial. I've heard that. Tommy used to surf.
There's this one bunch called Surf Soldiers. They mark their turf with an SS.
SS? What do you mean? Are they Nazis? Do they pick on minorities?
No, I don't think they go after any one particular group. They just don't like anybody they don't know.
Broad-minded them. Tell you, if you don't have too much action this morning, why don't you send somebody down to talk to them? Maybe it'll lead to a story.
Charlie, I'm not selling this. I'm not sure it means much.
I like it. Listen, a piece what you handed me yesterday. What is it the surfer say?
Right.
Go for it.
I'll do better when I get used to this stove.
Meal is super, Billy. Really? Pork chops are much better for you when they're well done.
Lamb chops, but thanks for trying.
The spurn, who can tell? You want to get that? Go out.
No, okay. Who is it?
Neighbor. Hi, I'm Louise Florence. I live at the 6067 Fairlawn, just down the block. Do you have a couple minutes?
Yeah, please come in.
Thank you.
Oh. Your chimes are wonderful. Oh. They will stop eventually. I'm Billy Newman.
Hello.
Ted McCovey.
Oh.
My husband.
Oh. Oh, I see you're still eating. I'm sorry. I should go and come back.
We're just finishing. Would you like to sit in our chair, Mrs. Ford?
No. I'll just be here a minute. You've just moved in, and so you should know what's going on. Are you buying or renting?
We bought. Is there something about the house?
Oh,
it's sliding, right? It's built on fill.
Oh, no. No, nothing like that.
Haunted. This is the one with the curse.
He's pulling your leg, Mrs. Florence.
I see. Did you happen to notice the house at 6006, just two doors down, the one with the strange people moving in and out?
No. What's the story?
Well, it's called Baldwin House. It's a halfway house for disturbed people. This businessman from back east, Mr. Lombardi, is moving a lot of lunatics in.
Lunatics?
They're straight out of mental institutions, literally, and they're living right down there.
When did this happen?
About 2 weeks ago, and we want them out. So we're circulating this petition demanding that the city attorney force them to move. They're in violation of the zoning, and all the neighbors have signed or will sign.
Well, Mrs. Florence, I'm sure this concerns you, but I'd like to study this before I sign anything.
You don't wait till something happens to you.
Like Billy said, let us look into it.
I think you'll find we're right. We're not just thinking about ourselves. We're doing it for the whole neighborhood.
We understand. Listen, thanks for coming by.
Good meeting you.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Set up that halfway house 2 weeks ago. 5 minutes after our escrow closed.
I know.
I'm telling you, sweetheart. Timing is everything.
Lou Grant will continue in a moment here on A&D.
One of the places we spend too much money is on reporters overtime.
We try to watch it, believe me.
Why can't you keep Metro on budget? They've gone over the past 3 months.
They're leaving out. We can't predict when something newsworthy is going to happen. If all hell breaks loose, we have to cover it, even if it's in the middle of the night or on a weekend.
Now, why would they send Rosenthal to wait outside a restaurant at midnight to interview a TV star? Who found that newsworthy?
Rosenthal. She's his favorite actress.
Excuse me.
Oh, yes, Mr. Grant. Come in.
Mrs. Pinchon, I asked to see you because Charlie and I were talking this morning. Charlie, have you mentioned this to Mrs. Pinchon?
Mentioned what?
The Denver record.
No.
You heard the record folded?
It's a tragedy. Oh. That was management's fault entirely. Watch the overtime.
Well, a lot of good people are now available with the record collapsing. I think we ought to look over their roster and grab a couple.
We're overstaffed now.
There are some attractive free agents.
Like who?
They've got a youngish investigative reporter I like named Iverson, and we certainly could use Rosemary Dolan.
Dolan? She's been around forever.
But she writes a highly individual, insightful column. It would be a big plus.
Any of these attractive free agents personal friends of yours, Mr. Grant?
No, this isn't a pitch to get a pal a job, honest.
Dolan's good, but if we're staffed, we're staffed.
Well, I figure we could take on more than we needed right now for the sake of getting some hot hitters. In 6 months, with people retiring, we'd be back to normal.
Carrying extra people can be costly.
Charlie, you were crazy about the idea when we discussed it this morning. Why are you spiking it now?
Because I had a meeting with finance since then.
Yes, that meeting's cooled me down a bit, too. Sorry, Mr. Grant. No Rosemary Dolan.
Whose idea was it to call yourselves surf soldiers?
I don't know. It was a couple of our ideas. Panfacer Can said, hey, how about surf soldiers? And we all said, all right.
Did you hear the SS? Stormtroopers were Hitler's own special corps.
What about them?
Did you have them in mind when you chose your name for the group?
No, we didn't have anybody in mind.
In other words, you're not modeling yourselves after Nazis.
Nazis? You mean like those freaks from Glendale Nazis? Those dudes with the black and white uniforms?
Yeah. You sympathize with them at all?
Did you ever see those guys? Fat, out-of-shape slobs. You could grab them here and get a handful of them.
Why do we want to go along with them for?
Well, I just mean, do you agree with their philosophy?
Look, SS means we're into surfing. Like, real intense. Fanatical, like those dudes back then.
See, we're kind of maniacs about our beach, and this is our stretch right here.
Where?
See those rocks down there? Three rocks, one's pointing.
Yeah.
You see that drain pipe about 300 yards? Between there and there is ours. And if you're not a surf soldier, you stay the hell out.
Because we don't want tourists, unlocals, or wannabes.
Wannabes?
People who wanna be surfers.
The beginners are the jerks. Just see, they wander in and they pollute the place.
When they come in, then what?
They're out there taking my waves and moving in on me, and they can't take a hint.
I'd just shoot my board at them.
That's right.
Shoot your board? But that thing's like a spear. Couldn't it kill somebody?
Not kill somebody. Just move them out.
It's beginning to look better. How much longer is this going to take?
Not long, not long. You guys, you don't mind if I take a few pictures, do you?
Don't take any of their waves.
Have you ever had to move surfers away? I mean, like another gang?
We took care of 34th Street one time.
What happened?
Once when their surf was flat, a bunch of guys came down here.
Pushed a couple of our guys around and started surfing on our beach.
So that night we stole their surfboards. We brought them down here to the beach and burned them. It's a real surf sacrifice.
So like when we were having the weenie bake, 34th Street guys showed up and we all started punching it out.
It was great. The cops came down and had to pry our guys off them.
We taught them a lesson, all right.
But you don't see anybody but surf soldiers out there now, do you? Well, it's looking really better. Come on, Pantface, let's go. See ya.
Lou Grant will continue in a moment here on A&E.
Morning.
Hi.
Yeah?
Stuart Hampton, Baldwin House. I'd like to do your gardening. Do you have a garden?
You're looking at him. But if I get fired or something, maybe we'll consider you.
Here's my card, just in case.
Thanks.
I live nearby, so, you know, if you're ever away or anything, I could look after things for you.
I'm hardly ever away.
Do you have a lot of gardening experience, Stuart?
Well, I take care of the yard at Baldwin House, and I do 6511 and 5900. Gardening's always been a hobby of mine. So we decided to make it a part of the program.
Your program?
My work program. We all have work programs. We work as janitors, hospital aides. We try and learn something so we can live on our own.
That's great. Wish we could help.
Where were you before Baldwin House?
State Hospital. Baldwin House is the first place that ever taught me anything. Really helped me.
It's good to hear. It's nice meeting you.
Don't lose my card.
Why don't we give him a chance?
No. Once I have the time, I'll mow the lawn. If I don't, it's not going to be Stuart.
Why not? He really wants the work.
Because I don't want to get involved with those people. And I sure don't want them hanging around here when I leave town.
Is that why you told them that you're never away?
Of course.
Why, you think they're dangerous?
Who wants to find out? Can we talk about this later? Where's my bag? If I don't get rolling, I'll never get to San Diego by noon.
Dad, we've got a nice new home here. Why don't we try to enjoy it?
I'm working on it, babe.
I kind of like this one. The moment I took it, I got knocked on my tail.
They got good action. Are these guys showing off for you?
Oh, not at all. They have great concentration. They could care less about somebody in the water with a camera.
We'll show them to Charlie at the budget meeting.
Okay. Bye. Billy just called in. She'll be late. The car won't start.
City Dust. This is Lou Grant. Harry Sandridge. Hey, Harry. How are you? First I remember you. It was back at the Minneapolis Tribune, wasn't it? Uh-huh. How are things back home? Good night. Denver. Oh, yeah, I heard. I'll ask around, but I don't think anyone's looking. Give me your number. Yeah. Well, good luck, Harry. Bye.
Another voice from the past?
Harry Sandridge. I didn't think I knew anyone on the record. I forget. People move around like I did.
Well, come on in, will you? A couple of days ago, we had a little chat about cutting back on the overtime, remember?
What about?
I was looking at Rossi's timesheets. He put down he started at 6:30 yesterday morning. Mm-hmm. What'd you have him chasing at that hour?
The surfers. For you, remember?
Why so early?
Well, I understand the wind is off the shore in the morning. It holds the waves back and they get a better ride.
And Rossi had to see that to get the story?
Well, he wanted to talk to them before they paddled out. It's a little hard to take notes while treading water, you know.
Oh. Well, in that case, I guess it's okay. That piece is working out. Did you see the art animal has on it?
Guy, it got me stoked. Made me want to jump into my trunks, grab my board, and shoot some too.
Good stuff.
Yeah, and he almost got killed doing it, which makes him even better.
We may use a couple of these. Have Layout come by my office after the meeting. I'd like to play with this.
I take it we're going big with the surf soldier stuff.
take it right.
That's good. I like it.
But I'm going to hold it up one day and promote it. How long does Rossi's story run as is?
He's got about 1,000 words.
We can use it all.
You're really hot for this, aren't you?
Yes, I am. Group of kids call themselves surf soldiers with SS emblems on their boards. Extremely territorial. Putting up signs, kicking people off their beach. I think they deserve some exposure.
I'm afraid of making them out to be more than they really are. They're just a small group, a squad at best. I don't want to blow them into a division.
I think people should be able to use the public beaches without getting muscled out by a gang of surf bums.
Yeah, it's a good Southern California story.
I just don't want us to overstate the case.
These guys like the sunshine. Let's put them in the warm light of public attention.
Hi, Scout. How's it going?
Hanging on.
I scouted 3 high schools and 2 JCs. Tomorrow I hit the universities.
See anything impressive so far?
Yeah. High school band knocked my socks off.
How's everything on the home front?
Oh, my battery was dead this morning. I had to take the bus to work.
You have to get a new battery. You can't just keep charging the old one.
The mechanic says it's just a short.
Our neighbor's been behaving themselves?
What do you mean?
You know what I mean. Baldwin House. Have you seen him around?
Well, just this morning.
What happened?
Nothing. One of the guys, he followed me to the bus and he sat behind me all the way to work.
Did he say anything?
No. Nothing. Ted, he didn't say a word.
Don't you think that's a little strange? Do me a favor. Don't let anybody in the house.
Not even the guys who are delivering the furniture?
I am serious. You gotta be on your guard, babe. Promise me.
I promise.
I'll be home tomorrow night. I love you.
I love you, too. Bye-bye.
Why don't we crop this one right here, make it more vertical?
I hate to disturb all his creativity, but can I get an answer on Rosenthal's vacation?
What's the problem?
Well, he wants to take 2 weeks, but he's only entitled to 10 days.
Yeah, why not? But tell him he only gets paid for 10.
Okay.
Yo, Lou, wait. Take a look at this. What do you think of it?
Not much. There's 3 graphs, tops.
I don't get it. Lou brought in the story and now he wants to dump it.
Station 14. Call the cops. Get a bunch of them down here fast.
Lou Grant will continue in a moment here on A&D. A&D returns to Lou Grant.
City News Service says at least 5 taken emergency so far. Ask them if there's anybody seriously hurt.
Hold on a minute. Police Pete says they don't have that yet. Well, how many young men are involved? About 30? You know who started it? Uh-huh. Okay, get back to me. Cops are saying it was that blankety-blank newspaper story that did it.
Do I get to fill in the blanks?
Morning.
Breaking news at the beach, Charlie.
I heard. Have you sent anybody down?
Rossi's on his way.
Good.
Quite a coincidence.
What do you mean, coincidence?
Well, we do this story on the surfers just as the place explodes.
Good timing. Go on, say it.
Say what?
I told you so, right?
Did I say I told you so?
No.
Well, I told you so.
Yep. That place was tense before we wrote about it. Those guys were leaning on people, kicking them off their beach. It was inevitable there'd be a blow-up. If anybody blames us, it's lame.
I got to hand it to a guy who's able to say, okay, I made a mistake.
Call for you, Lou. Denver.
Hey,
Hello? Yes, Mr. Walker. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. Sure. Why don't you send a resume and your clip file? Well, if Mr. Hume has one, no, don't send another. No, it's okay. I don't mind. I wish you luck. Bye. Charlie told the guy to check with me. Why couldn't he have said that we don't have anything?
Maybe he felt you should get to know him.
He heard Mrs. Pinchon turn us down on Rosemary Dolan. He can say no as well as I can.
I'm sorry, see what?
That boy from Baldwin House turned the sprinklers on me.
Why would he do that?
I don't know, because he's nuts, I guess. He probably knows I'm one of the people that's trying to get rid of them. They're just trying to intimidate us.
He's away from his desk right now. I'm the assistant city editor. Can I help you? Okay, wait a minute. I'll see if I can find him. Lou?
What?
A very calm and very angry lady wants to talk to the editor and nobody else.
You know who it is?
My guess is that it's a resident of Gilmore Beach.
Can you hear waves in the background? Lou Grant? Yes, ma'am. We're aware of what's happening down there. We're writing about it in the newspaper every day. No, we did not intend to stir up a riot. Calm and angry woman is no longer calm. No profanity, okay? Oh, lady. Listen, I'm gonna hang up. Excuse me. Bye. Women shouldn't cuss like that.
I got a call that the police in Gilmore and Sunset Beaches are closing their public parking.
What's the point?
To discourage outsiders from visiting for a few days. Keep people out until things calm down.
Isn't that going to create tension? Guy drives to the beach, can't find a place to park. That could make him sore.
Beautiful day. The kind of day makes you want to go to the beach and punch someone out.
What's the latest?
Fight in a taco joint right on the bicycle path. A guy from 34th Street and a surf soldier got hungry at the same time.
So the place wasn't big enough for both of them.
Guacamoles, tamale, and people splattered all over the place.
Do me a favor, when you write it up, don't make it sound cute.
Hold the guacamole.
Well, let's hope Charlie will ignore it.
City Desk, Donovan. No, he's out right now. Can I help you? Another beach report.
I gotta get away for a few minutes. Get some fresh air.
I'm sorry he's away from his desk right now, but if you'll give me a phone number, I'll have him call you as soon as he gets back. Okay.
Hey, Lou.
Jesse.
Did anybody speak to you about that piece Metro did on those surfaces?
I have heard a few comments.
Well, I live out in Gilmore Beach, and we've had trouble with those guys on and off for years.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the kids from Gilmore don't like the guys from Sunset. The beach kids put down a surface from the valley.
That's what I heard.
And, well, as soon as we get things all calmed down, your story comes out and starts it all up again.
You think the story did it?
Well, it said the surf soldiers beat up the kids from 34th Street. And now the 34th Street kids got to prove that that's a lie. You provoked a fight, Lou. Look, you're going up and down.
I wish I knew.
Thought you were taking a break for 5 minutes.
No place to hide.
Why don't you let the switchboard hold those calls? Or put them on the nut phone. That's what it's for.
Because I'm the city editor, and I've got to know how people are reacting.
It'll blow over.
I got this letter from the Gilmore Beach City Council inviting us to appear before tomorrow morning.
Mm-hmm. They want to holler at us with the SS story, I guess.
I guess. Anyway, they want to see the publisher, the managing editor, and the city editor. We don't want to put Mrs. Pinch on through that, agreed?
No, of course not.
And I have this meeting tomorrow at San Bernardino, so I'm afraid we've got the ball. Don't let them bully you. Take a reporter with you to cover it.
How do you like that? His story.
City Desk, Donovan. 1 minute, please. Denver again.
Lou Grant, how do you do? Yeah, I'm sorry to hear it. Yeah, I know. You're looking for a job. How would you like mine?
Mrs. McCovey, good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Joe Lombardi from Baldwin House. I know your neighbors have been around with their petitions, and I wanted you to hear our side, too.
My husband isn't home right now. Could you come back tomorrow morning?
Sure.
Mr. Lombardi, come on in.
Thank you.
Please sit down.
Thank you. Well, I guess you know half your neighbors want to shut us down. Mm-hmm. Actually, it's more than half, but who's counting?
Well, they're upset. There have been incidents.
That sprinkler thing, right? I mean, people act as though the boy attacked the woman. That was just an accident.
The boy did run away.
Well, of course. He didn't know how to deal with the situation. He was embarrassed. I don't know, people in this neighborhood don't seem to understand about emotionally disturbed people. All they care about is property values.
What's going to happen if they get enough signatures on that petition?
City Council will consider it and rule on it, hopefully in our favor.
And if they don't?
If they don't, I'll appeal and let the courts figure out who's right or wrong.
Are you a psychologist?
No, I'm not. Psychologist or a doctor or a psychiatric social worker. None of that. I'm just a volunteer. But I do know something about rehabilitation.
And how's that?
I have a son who they said was manic depressive. He was in and out of mental institutions all of his life. One time I brought him home for a visit and he was so over-medicated he didn't even know me or his mother. I pulled him out of that place. I figured I'd lost him anyway. He was so doped up. But then I put him with some folks who had a little neighborhood clinic where patients were eased back into the community. Well, they taught him how to get a job. They taught him how to handle his own medication. They treated him like a real person and how he responded.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, and now he works with kids, emotionally disturbed kids, just like he was.
Oh. It's very impressive. Hi, honey. How was the trip?
Exhausting. Bumper to bumper all the way to Escondido.
Ted, this is Mr. Lombardi from Baldwin House.
I want to invite both of you to visit us down there. When can you make it? Hey, how about Saturday afternoon? We'd like to have you look us over.
I can't make it Saturday.
Okay, Sunday.
Mr. Lombardi, I'll have to be honest with you. That house of yours bothers me. Ever since we moved in, we've been assaulted by petitions, by so-called gardeners. One of your residents even followed my wife one day.
Ted, that was nothing.
Well, I'm sick of it. I mean, I'm tired. I couldn't wait to get home so I could be alone with my wife, and I come in and I find you here.
I asked him in, Ted.
Mr. McCovey, you're unhappy to see me, and you're right. I don't blame you. I'm a professional nuisance. But tell me, what really bothers you about Baldwin House?
I'm concerned for my wife.
But our clients aren't dangerous. We don't take alcoholics, drug addicts, or people with a criminal record.
They still worry me. I mean, they're right out of mental institutions.
They have been discharged. I mean, people are so frightened, so hostile. Why not give them a chance? Why are you so convinced that they're dangerous?
I'm not convinced about anything yet.
We're trying to keep an open mind.
Good. That is all I ask. Come see us, please. It's important. Good night.
Embarrass you? Was that too rough on you?
No, you were all right.
I'm sorry. Maybe if I wasn't on the road all the time, I worry about you. I feel guilty about being away so much. If I had a normal job and one that kept me in town, maybe I wouldn't be so worried.
Oh, why do you think you have to protect me? I can take care of myself. I've been on my own for years.
Yeah, but you didn't live next door to those people.
Lou Grant will continue in a moment here on A&D.
I know what I should have asked him.
What's that?
I should have said, do you live around here? I mean, do you have a halfway house in your neighborhood? Why here?
Well, they said this was an ideal location because this is a stable neighborhood.
Well, not for long. You know, we could get hurt when it comes time to sell. There's a for sale sign on that little Spanish house. Another one across the street. People are starting to jump.
Are we thinking about selling? We've only been here 2 weeks.
It burns me up. I live in apartment buildings and motels all my life. I finally take the plunge, buy a house, and it's next door to an asylum.
Oh, it's not an asylum.
I don't know what it is. Nobody knows what goes on down there.
Cad, you're making a judgment. You've never been inside the place.
Well, I can fix that by taking Lombardi up on his invitation. I may go down there this morning.
Well, just don't go down there with a chip on your shoulder.
Billy, let me handle it. Okay?
Where are you going?
To the beach.
Don't forget your shovel and pail.
Gilmore Beach, City Council. You know the meeting that Charlie is ducking by going to San Bernardino? I'm not looking forward to it.
I took that call. They really do just want our side of it.
The problem is, I think I'm on their side.
How bad can it be?
Mr. Grant, we're not just disappointed. We're furious with the Tribune for printing an article that caused a near riot in our community.
I understand that.
I'm not sure that you do.
We have special problems down here. Our beach is a limited resource with more and more people wanting to use it. It's crowded and it's becoming more so.
I understand that.
We had the situation under control until you printed that article.
Did you know that this is the worst incident of violence in over a year?
Do you have any idea how many people were injured?
We reported that there were at least 10 who were treated as outpatients.
Could you tell me why the Tribune did this to us?
It wasn't our intention to do anything to Gilmore Beach. We felt that the surfing phenomena, the lifestyle, competition for territory, even the violence, were worthy of a story.
Why did you highlight these surf soldiers? Why did you choose to single out the worst element in our community?
And why did you stir up the rivalry between 34th Street and the surf soldiers? You knew that would make trouble.
We could not predict that, sir.
Our boys have been surfing all their lives. They're jealous of their little piece of beach. They see it constantly invaded, and they see it constantly shrinking. They're a tough, competitive bunch. And they're ideal subjects to be ignited by a cynical press.
I don't feel the Tribune's attitude can be called cynical.
Well, do you feel your handling of the story showed a sense of responsibility?
I stand by my newspaper.
Thank you, Mr. Grant. You're excused.
Why don't we combine the last two graphs?
Why don't we?
I'll hold on to the quote, jump to the last one. You worried about something?
Why?
You're tense. You're tapping on an SOS on my shoulder.
Oh, sorry.
What is it?
I am worried about Ted. That halfway house in our neighborhood has got him a little bonkers. He went down there this morning. I haven't heard from him. I'm trying him again. If you can spare me on my lunch hour, I'm going to run home.
Go.
Thanks.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Thanks. I'm looking for my husband, Ted McCovey. Is he here?
Sure he is. Come on in.
Thanks.
I'm in the bullpen. This game is a laugher. I mean, like we're leading 9-1. But Dougal is the antsiest manager ever lived. And when the pitcher walks one guy, I mean, it's two outs in the bottom of the eighth, mind you. He signals to me to get up the left-hander. Well, left-hander is not about to warm up. In fact, he has snuck up into the bleachers and is making out with some baseball groupie. So what am I going to do? Well, in Amarillo, you can only see part of the bullpen from the dugout. So I wave okay to Dougal, go into my crouch, and pretend I'm catching balls from this pitcher that, well, he can't see. I mean, there I am, throwing imaginary balls and catching them. And the people in the bleachers, well, I mean, they're really cracking up. I mean, they thought I was nuts. Sorry.
Well, that's okay. I used to play catch by myself, too.
Listen to this.
Ted made a big hit.
Another time I was
catching. They're delighted with his baseball stories.
Oh, he loves to tell them. I'm afraid I thought there was going to be trouble when he came down here this morning.
Well, first of all, everybody was very happy to see him. They showed him all around the place. But I think what really made him a convert was when he found he'd been talking for 10 minutes with a man that he thought was a doctor who turned out to be a resident here.
What kind of illness are most of these people suffering from?
Let's just say they've had their troubles. But this normalization, this method of teaching living and working skills is quite successful.
It must be very gratifying for you.
It is. And another thing that I'm grateful for, the city council, believe it or not, this morning they voted that we were entitled to stay.
Congratulations.
Has Charlie come back in?
Hi, Lou. Nobody's due. How'd you enjoy the Gilmore Beach City Council?
They were very hospitable. All five of them pounded on me for half an hour, but I just took it and they finally got arm weary.
Did you give them something back?
No, I didn't. I think they had a right to be mad.
Gentlemen!
Charlie?
Who is San Bernardino?
Smoggy. May I see you in my office for a minute, Lou? I'm afraid we have something to straighten out.
We certainly do. Charlie, I went down to the Gilmore Beach City Council meeting this morning.
I know, thanks. Lou, your people went 200 hours into overtime last week. We talked about this, and you promised to watch it.
The hell with the overtime.
What?
You heard me. We got something more important to talk about than money.
What's that?
The integrity of this newspaper. I went down to Gilmore Beach this morning and got pummeled by that city council because of that damn surfer story. We gave a handful of beach bums more coverage in one day than they should get in a lifetime. We provoked trouble in a town where they're trying very hard to maintain peace. We hurt them, Charlie.
You won't drop this, will you? You're second-guessing me again. Don't tell me after the fact I made a mistake. Tell me how the readers are going to respond tomorrow to something that we're writing today.
I told you I was worried at the time.
Well, damn it!
No. Mr. Grant?
Switch on.
I won't be a moment. I know you're busy.
It can wait.
I have something to say to you that should not be said on the phone or in a memo, and certainly not behind your back. It should be said to you face to face.
What's that?
You'd think I'd have learned to listen by now, but I guess I'm just slow. You urged me to hire some of the people laid off by the demise of the Denver Record. I ignored you. Well, this morning, I read Rosemary Dolan's farewell column in the Denver Record's final edition. She made me cry. Then she made me laugh. And before I was halfway through it, I'd grabbed the phone to call and tell her what a great column she'd written. And then I found myself offering her a job here on the trip. She turned us down. Somebody else beat us to her.
That's too bad.
Yes, it is. And the next time I don't listen, give me a good swift kick, please. I don't tell you often enough how valuable you are to me. I think you're a fine newsman and a good team.
putting Rossi and Rosenthal on the flood control story. I think it's called for.
Fine. Use your own judgment on that.
Thanks.
Just watch the overtime.
He was a kid who never had a chance. A teenage boy is found murdered in his foster home on Law and Order tonight. Now, officers take aim at an illegal rifle club on Police Story, next on A&E.